Each of these solar cells is independent. They're not connected to each other. If we want to get a bigger voltage, we need to connect these up in series, one after the other. To connect them in series, I'm going to connect the negative of cell number one to the positive of cell number two. Then the negative of cell number two to the positive of cell number three, and the negative of cell number three to the positive of cell number four. This time I'll connect in to the motor on the energy testing station. I need to go from the positive of cell number one to one side of the motor, then connect the other side of the motor to the negative of cell number four. I will adjust the lamps so that they're spreading reasonably evenly across. I'll turn that off. Now it'll be interesting to see what voltage we're getting from having our four cells connected in series. So I'll take a voltmeter, connect that across the motor, and turn this around to 2 volts. And I'm getting about 1.55 volts across that. So each of the voltages from the solar cells, around about 0.5, is adding up to that. If I disconnect the motor and just connect across the solar cells, our screen has gone to number one, which means that it's gone off scale. So I've got to turn around to the next scale, and without any load, without any current running through the solar cells, I'm getting 2.13. Now, if we want to measure the power that we're generating to go through that motor, we'll need to bring in another meter to measure the current. So I'll take out one side of that, put it into the common, take another wire from the meter and connect it across to the motor. That's measuring current, so I'm going to put that around to 200 milliamps. And now to measure the voltage across, we're now getting 1.47 volts and 66 milliamps. If we multiply those together, we'll get how much power we've got in milliwatts.